why I do this business is, or how I can serve the community is by being able to give them an opportunity to work, a fair opportunity. I cannot be everywhere, I cannot control what happens, but I can at least make sure that everyone has that opportunity. So my name is Ankit Agarwal. I was born and brought up in Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh, that is India. Then I started this company, Kanpur Flower Cycling Private Limited, where we collect waste flowers from temples and convert them into eco-friendly products that have wide markets and that replace already existing chemical-based products. I was in Kanpur, the place where I was born and brought up, and I had invited my Czech friend Kuba to visit me. That date was Makar Sankranti, which is an Indian festival that marks the ending of winters and welcoming of summers. So all the farmers, children, mothers, everyone takes a dip in the river Ganges in that dirty, slimy water. We didn't even want to touch the water, it was so dirty. Kuba and I started talking about the river Ganges, and I told him about the religious significance of the river Ganges. And he asked me a question: if this river is so sacred, why is it so polluted? I blame the fecal sludge, the industrial waste, the household waste and everything. And he asked me a question: why don't you do something about it? And I was like, this is the Ganges. How can anyone do anything about it? And the moment I said this, a nearby temple dumped in a truckloads of flour in the river. And there was this vibgyorish chemical layer that was formed on the water. And I was like, wow, I had never even thought of temple waste as pollution. We Indians like have been doing this for centuries. Every year, we Indians put in about 8 million tons of waste flowers in the waters. All the pesticides that are used to grow these flowers mixes with the river water, making it highly toxic. That is the leading cause of diarrhea, hepatitis, and severe cholera across India and Bangladesh, where the water flows. And no one has ever thought about this. So I started talking to all the stakeholders involved in the supply chain of the flowers, the farmers, the markets, what happens to these flowers. Finally, I decided to form a company where we can collect waste flowers and do some products. We started making incense out of temple flowers. We make incense that are completely chemical free, which are hand rolled in natural essential oils. Luckily, one day I came across this strange organism that had developed upon the pile of one of our unused flowers, and we were able to make a material which behaves completely like leather and is made from hay and flowers. This is a material completely made from waste, has a superior life than leather. With a animal leather, you have a fixed size hide, and it takes animal takes 3 years to grow. With our experiments and our R&D, you can do the same thing in 27 days. So styrofoam is the fifth biggest pollutant on Earth. As of now, mankind does not know a way to recycle. You have to either compress it or burn it or put it in soil. And once you put it in soil, it stays there for more than 1,000 years. So we've been able to make a biodegradable, home compostable alternate to styrofoam made from flowers, and it's price effective. So this whole cycle of the flowers was complete. When we started, at that point of time, we would struggle finding people who would want to work with us, pick up flowers, segregate them. So one day, these two women, they came and they were very happy to work with us. This went on for a month. They happily completed all the work. I asked them, like, why? What like motivates you to be here? So then they told me about the job that they were doing, that they were manual scavengers. They'll go home to home, pick up human excreta, keep it up on their heads and dispose it off.
They used to be manual scavengers who scrape the feces with their bare hands. So in that profession, you can just imagine there is no dignity, and for livelihood, they need to struggle a lot.
They said that no one ever gave them another option to work. They had to do this, and even their children will have to get into this. And when they started working with us, first of all, they don't have to go to home to home. They just have to come to a single workplace. That's one. Second, they felt good about themselves that they're working with temple flowers, and they felt that they're helping, doing some God's work. And they'll help clean the river Ganges, which is a goddess. We'll be able to do around 7,200 women, but I've set that goal of 5,000. What I believe is change will not happen in this generation. it will happen in the next generation. When the kids of the woman that we are able to employ start going to school, their next generation will be liberated from scavenging. Seed has been that cushion that has helped us understand the different processes, different systems, and how the company can be managed in a better way so that we can get our full potential. The communication gap that was there is being bridged. Everyone knows what the company is doing and what's in it for them.
We all share a common intent. We share a common intent of flower cycling. We share a common intent of women employment. We share common views about the society. And that is why all of us are working together to achieve a goal. We all want to see it flourish.
With the seed A raise, we'll almost be 7 times of the revenue that we're doing as our factories come up. They've already secured orders from biggest household brand names in the country for our Fluoroform packaging. So now we're just waiting for the factories to be set up and start the supplies. Problems will only be solved if they can solve themselves, if they are sustainable. If solving the problem can bring you money, then more and more people will get into this thing, right? Only then the problem will be solved. Many times people ask me, like, don't you feel that this person is trying to replicate your model, and do you feel that threat? I always say, see, the problem is so huge, you need at least 10,000 people like me to solve this problem. I think that's the equation.